శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః. శ్రీ గురు చరిత్ర చాప్టర్ 13. నామధారక సెడ్ గురుదేవ్, శ్రీ గురు ఇనిషియేటెడ్ సన్యాస టు మాధవ అట్ ప్రయాగ్. ప్లీజ్ లెట్ మీ నో వాట్ అకర్డ్ లెటర్. సిద్ధ సెడ్, శ్రీ గురు లివ్డ్ అట్ ప్రయాగ్ ఫర్ సమ్ డేస్. హీ హ్యాడ్ మెనీ డిసైపుల్స్ దేర్. దీస్ ఇంక్లూడెడ్ బాల సరస్వతి, కృష్ణ సరస్వతి, ఉపేంద్ర సరస్వతి, మాధవ సరస్వతి, సదానంద సరస్వతి, ధ్యానజ్యోతి సరస్వతి అండ్ మైసెల్ఫ్ యాజ్ ద సెవెన్ చీఫ్ డిసైపుల్స్. హీ దెన్ విజిటెడ్ హోలీ ప్లేసెస్ ఇన్ ద సౌత్ అండ్ కేమ్ టు కరంజా. హీ వాజ్ ఇన్వైటెడ్ డోర్ టు డోర్. ద మదర్ రీకలెక్టెడ్ దట్ హీ వాజ్ శ్రీపాద శ్రీవల్లభ అండ్ కాల్డ్ హర్సెల్ఫ్ ఫార్చునేట్. షీ టోల్డ్ దిస్ టు హర్ హస్బెండ్ when both requested him to liberate them from the worldly sea. Sri Guru said, if a person accepts sannyas, he is 42 generations, 21 parental and 21 maternal are liberated. Their issues have no fear of god of death. You will see that your sons live for 100 years. Then you will go to Kashi, the holy place of liberation. There is no doubt about this. Ratnai, his sister, requested Sri Guru, I am entangled in a family trap. Please take me out of this. I want to do penance. Sri Guru, serve your husband and this will liberate you. One has to suffer as per one's fate. Females can win over the worldly sea only with the help of their husbands. Thinking the husband to be Sri Shiva, serve him. This is what the Vedas, Shastras and Puranas dictate. She further asked, you know the past and the future also. Please tell me what is my future. Sri Guru, in the previous birth, you hit a cow with your legs. You made the neighboring couples quarrel among themselves. So you will develop leprosy for hitting the cow and your husband will leave you and be a sannyasi. You shall live amicably for some years. In old age, your husband will accept sannyas. When you have leprosy, you will see me. You come to Papa Vinashi on the bank of Bhima River in the south. Nearby is the Bhima Amarja Sangamam and Gangapur. After bathing in the Papa Vinashi, you will be cured of leprosy. Sri Guru then went to Trayambakeshwar, the place of penance of Gautam Muni. Sri Shankar was pleased by the penance of Gautam, who brought Godavari on the earth for the benefit of the people. Sri Guru travelled by the bank of Godavari and came to Manjirika. A learned Brahmin Madhvaranya lived here. He adored Narasimha. Seeing that Sri Guru appeared just a Narasimha, he bowed to him and praised him in Sanskrit. Sri Guru was pleased and he appeared before him in his divine form. Madhvaranya prostrated before him and chanted prayers. Sri Guru then blessed him. Sri Guru then went to Brahmeshwar. Here a Brahmin suffered from the acute colic pain. He was rolling in the sand of the river due to severe pain. He had to be on fast for several days. Whenever he dined, he had severe pain. He was intending to give up his life by drowning himself in the river and thus getting rid of acute colic pain. Knowing his intentions, Sri Guru asked his disciples to bring the Brahmin to him. When he was brought before him, Sri Guru asked him, why are you committing suicide? This is a great sin. What is your misery? Brahmin, I am a burdensome on this earth. I dine once in a fortnight or a month, but I have to bear a very severe colic pain. The body lives on food, and if food cannot be taken, how can this body survive? Sri Guru, I shall give you a medicine. You have a full meal today. The Brahmin was much encouraged with the Sri Guru's word. In the meanwhile, the officer of the town came to the river for bath. Seeing Sri Guru, he bowed to him with reverence. Sri Guru inquired, may I know your name and whereabouts? The officer said, I belong to Kaundinya Gotra and I am a Brahmin of Apastamba Shaka. My name is Sayamdev. I come from Kanchi. I am serving here as a town officer of a Muslim ruler for 1 year. I feel myself very fortunate to see Thai. Sins are wiped off by seeing the Ganga. Heat of the body subsides by seeing the moon. And poverty is destroyed by the favor of Kalpataru. But by seeing thyself along, all these three miseries are wiped off and one gets all the four valors. Sayamdev humbly expressed, Gurudev, he dined yesterday. after 1 month and subsequently he had severe colic pain. If he is given food today and if he dies, shall I not be responsible for his death? Sri Guru, I am giving medicine which should be fried and given to him. Besides, give him food containing sugar and milk. Do not have any doubt in the mind. Sayamdev agreed and further requested Sri Guru to grace his home by his presence and accepts alms at his house. Sri Guru gladly accepted his invitation. Sri Guru, three Brahmins and other disciples came to Sayamdev. Sayamdev's wife Jakai was devoted wife. Both worshipped Sri Guru ceremoniously. They worshipped the disciples also. All had a happy dinner that day. The colic pain of the Brahmin disappeared instantly by the grace of Sri Guru. All were wonderstruck to see this miracle. Sri Guru blessed Sayamdev, saying, "Your family will flourish and devotion of Guru will be continued in the later generations of your family." Thus, chapter 13 completed. Om Sri Guru Bhyo Namaha.